Our world has changed permanently. With cyber attacks on the rise, how can we secure ourselves in this new reality?
Hi guys, this is gonna be a reaction video on a ransomware interview that I did a while ago. And it was interesting because back then it was kind of my thoughts on how it had evolved, how ransomware had evolved to the point where 5 years ago they were attacking, and how we view ransomware as a threat to our customers. It's been a while ago, so let's take a look at what I said, and let's see if those things hold true, if what I said kind of makes sense still or not. Let's take a look. We saw ransomware in the beginning that would take advantage of the whole system. It would just prevent you from accessing your own system and then asking you money in order for you to come back. And then again, it started becoming obsolete because an end user, I can't access my system. Would I pay $100 for it? If I don't really have data, I format it and start all over again. I don't pay 100 euros for, you know, I just install again. So that strategy started becoming obsolete. What did the bad guys do? They realized that that strategy was only good when the data that the computer was holding was valuable. So I might as well ask ransom for the data. And that's what they're doing now. That was the evolution.
This is still true. I mean, in the beginning, what the bad guys wanted was to prevent you from accessing the computer. So the ransom was being asked for the computer. Now they realize that, okay, I can format the computer, that's done, you know? So it doesn't bother me, that kind of threat. So what they did is they tried to go for your data. And if they hold ransom for your data and your data is really valuable, then you're more likely to pay for it, right? What I failed to mention here, because it didn't exist 5 years ago, was that the evolution, the next evolution was to proactively look for targets and not only encrypt the data, but also steal it and try to extort money from it. So it's not only I have encrypted your data, you can't access it, pay if you want it, but also I have your data now and I'm going to release it to the public. Are you interested in that? Pay. So it's some sort of a blackmail situation that they have evolved, since they understood, the criminals understood, that they have access to very valuable data.
So it's been evolving over time. The moment that somebody reinvented or revamped the whole ransomware strategy and being successful with it, then everybody else in that same industry started to move on, progressively move on to it. And then that it's been happening ever since, right? Encryption is just another tool. It's just put.
It's worth noting that this is the third evolution from there, right? But yes, they are now getting the data, stealing the data. So that's the new part that we're not seeing. In reality, it's not an evolution of the software, but it's an evolution of the business plans. So since it works, the bad guys have been tweaking their business plan to make money. Now, you want to access your data? Pay. Now, I also have the data. You don't want me to release it? Pay. So it's an evolution in the business plan rather than in just one single threat.
Now, if I get your stuff, your personal stuff, in my strong box, and say, hey, I won't give you the combination, just give me the money, is that a bad use of a safety locker? It probably is, yeah. It probably is.
I'm talking here about abuse of technology. So certainly ransomware is abusing the modern cryptography, the capability of computers of encrypting in a way that it's very difficult for anybody else to know the key. Now, is this abuse of cryptography? Certainly. The new side of this is that the bad guys now, they're not relying on them infecting you with ransomware. but they are proactively hacking into systems. They not only send you email and hope that some admin person double click on it.
If you think that this is bad for the end user, it's much worse for the corporation. Imagine salary data, financial data, that is completely vital. Those guys need that data. Now, if worst case scenario, they have no other recourse, they have no data, they data backups, they have no other recourse other than paying, they pay anything, because it's vital for the continued survival of the company. So that's much worse put into a corporate scenario than in a home scenario.
This is true, and it's true in such a way that the bad guys are trying to avoid just any infection nowadays. They don't want to infect you or me. They want to infect the big hospital, the big corporation, the big bank. So that's why they proactively target. They know who they're dealing with. They target exclusively those people. So that is more true than ever.
We do have a lot of good things going. We have traditional detection, right? Traditional detection, it's always there. It's baseline, but it's good. And more importantly, we have web reputation services, which means that any bad link that we already know of, being because it's hosted on a bad IP, being because it's hosted on a bad neighborhood, what I recommend instead is that you and everybody runs a solid backup strategy. You have to have a solid backup strategy in place so that whenever this happens...
All of this is still true. I mean, they all hold still true. We do have a solid detection capabilities for ransomware and for any other malware, for that matter. But since malware, this kind of malware, ransomware in particular, is being spread through the network nowadays, then that gives us also the capability to put our agents into the network and analyze the network. So on top of regular the malware detection heuristics and the web reputation like we had 5 years ago, we now have agents that are placed on the network analyzing the normal traffic of the network.
Place so that whenever this happens, this or any other data corruption, you have to treat ransomware as any other data corruption. What if tomorrow your light goes off and your hard disk fails? What happens? You know, are you going to ask for any sort of compensation from the hard disk guy or from the electric company? Maybe you would, but you're still screwed because you don't have your data, right? So just as any other data corruption, you have to have solid backup plan in place. If you don't, then you're subject to data loss.
And that's still true. I mean, at the end of the day, we have to treat this as this ransomware as a data corruption issue. So you have to have a backup plan in place. If you don't, then at any point you might be subject to data loss. I mean, this is how it is. You have to treat ransomware as a fire or any hazard that just ruins data, destroys data. So I think it's pretty much, we're in the third evolution of what I was telling 5 years ago. Now they've gone out of their way, and they're trying to get any hole that you might have, like any web front end that might have a vulnerability, any strange ports that you don't even know you're using, and there's a vulnerability behind one of your servers. They're trying to use those back doors, so to speak, in order to enter the network, and once they're in, then they identify which server is the most interesting, and then that's the one they infect, encrypt, and ask for ransom, and steal the data from and try to blackmail you with it. That's their business plan. That's what we have to have in mind in order to fight with them. Well, hopefully this kept you up to date on what's happening now compared to 5 years ago, and yeah, thank you guys.